Hello and welcome to our 8th grade promotion video. Unfortunately, we are not able to do this in person, so we've had to be a little creative this year in order to honor and congratulate our 8th graders on their successful completion of their middle school experience as we wish them a successful journey to high school. We will have some videos from teachers, a few speeches from students, and of course, the calling of all of our 8th grade names, as well as some pictures, so please stay tuned and enjoy the rest of this video.
Hello, 8th graders. This is Ms. Lyons. I wanted to wish you all of the best of luck as you move on to high school. I know that you are going to represent Bullet Lick Middle School in a true Bobcat fashion, and I cannot wait to see what amazing things you guys do. Good luck and have a great summer.
8th graders, I know this is not the ending any of us had envisioned. I know you were looking forward to spending the last few months with your classmates and teachers, attending dances and ceremonies. Hold on to all the memories that you made at Bullet Lick Middle School. Cherish those. This is just the beginning of figuring out who you are. Dream big dreams. Make good choices. Go out there and change the world. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Hey, 8th graders. I know this isn't exactly the way you envisioned the end of your 8th grade year going, and we had so many more fun lessons and activities and 8th grade rites of passage that we were supposed to get to experience together. But sometimes life is like that, and you don't always get to control what is handed to you. But what's important is what you do with it now. One of my favorite quotes that I would have shared with you on the last day of school is this. The important thing is this. To be able at any moment to sacrifice what we are for what we could become. I've always loved that quote, and I hope that it's something that you love in the future. For me, it means that sometimes we have to take a leap of faith and step out of our comfort zone, and I hope that sometimes in high school you might have to do that to become a better person. It could be standing up to your friends when they aren't being so kind, or trying out for a new club or a sport, or maybe taking a class that you think might be a little challenging for you. And what I hope is that when you do those things, that you find that it makes you a better person in the end. I cannot wait to see what you do in the future, and I hope you stay in touch so that I can follow you along your path. Bye.
Hi, 8th grade Bobcats. I know this year isn't what any of you imagined or what any of us imagined for you. I'm so proud of you that despite it all, you've kept your head up and you've persevered. I just want to read a little snippet of this book. You may recognize it. Oh, the Places You'll Go by Dr. Seuss. You'll get mixed up, of course, as you already know. You'll get mixed up with many strange birds as you go. So be sure when you step, step with care and great tact, and remember that life's a great balancing act. Just never forget to be dexterous and deft, and never mix up your right foot with your left. And will you succeed? Yes, you will indeed. 98¾% guaranteed. Kid, you'll move mountains. So, be your name Buxbaum or Bixby or Bray or Mordecai, Ali, Van Allen, O'Shea. You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting. So, get on your way. Remember to persist through life's challenges. Learn and grow through them. We are proud of you. We miss you. Congratulations, BLMS, class of 2020.
Thank you. The days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you wanted to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same thing. But you never forget all the ones who love you and the place you left. I hope you always forgive and you never regret, and you help somebody every chance you get. Oh, you find God's grace in every mistake, and always give more than you take. But more than anything, yeah, more than anything, my wish for you.
Every year, the 8th grade teachers come together to decide on two students for the most prestigious award that our school offers, Mr. and Mrs. Bobcat. When I tell the teachers about this award, I ask them to think of students who excel in all areas. I tell them to think of students who are well-rounded leaders, who are involved in extracurricular activities, helpful to their peers and to teachers, and motivated to do well academically. For me, I think of students who demonstrate the qualities that I hope my future children demonstrate as well. This year, the vote for Mrs. Bobcat was almost unanimous among the teachers, and I get the privilege of telling you about our winner. I met this young lady 3 years ago when she tried out for my cheer team. She was excited and full of energy, and I remember praying for the days when she would mature and calm down just a little bit more. And she did. Over the years, I've watched as she's become a leader not only on the team, but in the classroom and in every other club and sport that she has participated in. And trust me, she has participated in a lot of clubs and sports. She is a model student academically and is always begging for ways to push her learning even further. That same motivation has landed her a spot in the very prestigious Bullitt County Advanced Math and Science program next year. She's kind-hearted and she cares for her classmates and her teachers. Her teachers would agree that she makes teaching fun for us because she is so eager to learn. And her classmates, who I'm sure have already figured out who I'm talking about, would agree that her friendly personality and leadership make them feel welcome and included in class. It's my honor to name this year's Mrs. Bobcat, Miss Chloe Martin. Congrats, Chloe. You deserve this.
It is my great privilege to present this year's Mr. Bobcat to the 8th grade. Teachers came up with a unanimous or nearly unanimous vote for a male student who epitomizes the values of the Bobcat community. The Bobcat Award is not given solely for having the highest grades, although this person has exactly that. The Bobcat Award is not given for athletic prowess, although once again, this person has the distinction of that as well. No, the Bobcat Award is given for the person who is best poised to be our ambassador to the larger community. That person does not nearly say the words perseverance, progress, and pride. They live them every day by their powerful example, leading us to be better people by their very presence in our lives. And for that reason, this year's Mr. Bobcat is presented to Carter McBroom. Congratulations, Carter. Well deserved, sir. Good luck and Godspeed.
Challenges are what makes life interesting. Overcoming them is what makes life meaningful. By Joshua J. Maureen, is one of the quotes that helped me through the 8th grade. I had many challenges and I know most of y'all did too. But look where we are. We're heading into another chapter of our lives. The petty drama, the toxic friendships, the breakups are difficult challenges we have to face as a teenager. But we still walked those halls of Bullet-Lick Middle School proud and happy. We walked with challenges within us, but smiles on our faces. Some of you students think that school is irrelevant or a waste of time. But if we didn't have school, would we be the people we are now? Would we know what we want to be when we be older? School leads to a better life, a better career. School is and leads to an education which leads to success. If you want success, you need to go to school. You should be a person who finishes high school, not the person who drops out. We all have our own personalities. We are our own selves. But if, however, we didn't have school, we wouldn't know how to be in the NBA, or be a professional bowler, or be a lawyer, or any other professional, or have another career. Because they look at your education, which is required in so many careers, in addition to your abilities. We all became different people throughout these 3 years at Bullet-Lick. I came to Bullet-Lick in the middle of 6th grade. I was scared. I thought that no one would like me. I walked into my first class, 2nd period, and I was scared. But then someone said that they remember me. They remember going to school with me. It made me happy to know that I could make friends. I was a really shy person. I wasn't a person to talk to. I met a lot of people who helped me, but I met my best friend. We were both scared to say anything to each other. But he finally talked to me. He helped me through anything. He helped me be an outgoing person I am now. Our 7th grade year, the year that we became a family, the year that we got to be ourselves. I became myself. Our 7th grade year still had a lot of drama, but it didn't stop us from living our lives. We got to be what we wanted to be last year. I got really down last year. I was depressed. But I had a person to make me happy every day. And he helped me with my problems. He was the best friend that anyone could ask for. I had a lot of people who helped with everything I was going through. We made each other happy. We were a family. Lastly, this year, the eighth grade year, the year that we all waited for, we were ready to visit our future high school. We were ready to leave the school with an amazing dance at the end. Leave the school with our friends. We were ready to graduate in a few months. We wanted to get K-prep over with. We wanted to say goodbye to all of our favorite teachers. We were expected to come back and rock the rest of the school year. Eighth graders, we weren't the people who we were last year. We stopped talking to each other. We were strangers. COVID-19 might have ruined a lot of things that we were headed for, but we can't see each other. The quarantine changed a lot of things. Some of us lost family members. Some of us lost friends. But if we weren't stuck in quarantine, would we know how to pick up after ourselves? Would we know that you have yourself and that's all that matters? Just remember, everyone is here for every one of you guys. I want to give a big thank you to all the teachers that have taught us throughout these years. I want to give a big thank you for Ms. Dixon for helping me go through that rough patch. I want to thank Ms. McGlasson for believing in me, for helping me be the person I came up to be. I want to thank Ms. Flores for making everything funny and everyday fun. And lastly, I want to give a huge thank you to my favorite teacher, Ms. Easton, for giving me the courage to be anything, to do anything. Without you, I wouldn't have done anything. I wish all of you the best. I'm so happy for all of you guys, and I wish a great life ahead of y'all. Congratulations, 8th grade class of 2020. Live it up. Live life to the fullest.
Dear 8th grade class of 2020, hi, my name is Chloe Martin for those of you who don't know me. Moving on, taking the next step, going out of your comfort zone. It's hard. That is exactly what we are doing. We are saying goodbye to middle school, the place we've been for 3 years. It literally feels like we just started. Now, we are going forward to high school. It will be here before we know it. We are all united because of this. That isn't the only thing, though. We couldn't leave this and not recall all of the memories made. Every one of us had a different perspective or experience through middle school. However, if you come down to it, we all can remember the big things we did together. Whether we were just laughing at each other's jokes in class, talking at lunch, hanging out with each other on the weekends, going to assemblies, field trips, bobcat blasts, and sporting events, we were always having fun. When you read between the lines, there were always people who made an impact on your life. I can specifically remember having some of my favorite memories at cheer practices, competitions, and games, always giggling with my team and coaches about our inside jokes. Also, whenever I participated in things like KYA, FCA, Beta, track, volleyball, and being a VIP, that was always lots of fun. Some may have made their forever friends, met their favorite teachers, or have become happier people and made some of their best memories. As we start a new chapter, I know it can be scary. A whole new school with so many new people. Everyone is telling us it will be so much more difficult. That is only for the majority of us. Some are transferring, moving, or don't even know what will be next. It's a lot to take in. This won't be the first time that we've moved on, though. We went from preschool to kindergarten to fifth grade, and some of us have moved before. I know that we will make new friends. We will have great times with them, but we won't forget where we all came from. We won't forget the people we spent every day with. We won't forget all the memories. I don't want to think of this as goodbye. I want to think of this as see you later. Even though we are socially distant, we are not distant in our minds. We are still moving on together. Even though we can't see each other face to face, we are still making memories. In a way, it helps us know that when we move on, we don't have to separate. It helps us know who we can count on and who will always be there for us. It helps us know that we are never alone and will always have each other. Even though I wonder what might have happened during these last 2 months of eighth grade, at the eighth grade dance, and how our graduation would have been, I always remind myself, we will see each other later, and this was not goodbye, because we will get through this. We will be able to move on together, and we will be able to live out the future ahead of us. I want to thank everyone, including my family, teachers, including my cheer coach, Mrs. Tally, and all of my peers for believing in me, making me stronger, giving me the amazing middle school experience I had, and shaping me into the person I am right now. Thank you for all the laughs, friendships, inside jokes, and great times. I want to leave with this quote by Eleanor Roosevelt. The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. I hope that we can still dream of the great future ahead and of us moving on together. Thank you.
To close, I first want to thank all of our parents and guardians for the hours of support you have shown during the last 3 years, during normal times, but even more so because of the time you have spent helping your students be successful during our NTI period. I also want to thank you students for the resiliency you have shown. It is this resiliency that will help make sure that you come out of this even stronger than you went in. Students, the characteristic of this class that has defined this group of students over the last 3 years is passion. Passion is an intense and driving feeling of conviction. Students, you have shown this through your time in the classroom, in athletics, and through your relationships with each other, with your teachers, and with your family members. It is this passion that tells me you will achieve greatness in high school and beyond. Continue to seek out what you are passionate about, and you will find success. It is with a heavy heart that I do this digitally. It is much more enjoyable to have this in person with a great crowd and with all of our students present. Unfortunately, that is not possible. But it does not change the joy I've had in serving as your principal for the last 3 years. Students, I thank you for all that you have taught me and the relationships that I have formed through your 3 years at Bullet Lick, and I wish you the best of luck in high school, and I hope that you have a great and wonderful summer.